else are we getting it and what's important to do? So I think having a real consciousness about creating as much of a plastic-free lifestyle as you can is important. And even myself, I teach this and treat patients all day long, and I'm still working on it. As I was getting ready and taking a shirt out of my closet to get dressed for this talk, I thought, wow, look at my hangers. They're all plastic. I need to switch to wooden hangers. And so plastic is everywhere. But a couple of tips to get you started. First of all, if you're still using your microwave, please don't. But if you must, and we'll talk about that another time, but at least use glass containers in your microwave. When you're heating up things in plastic and microwave, you are just flooding your system with the toxins from the plastic. If you are drinking coffee and going to Starbucks, which I was just traveling this past week, and I was in the airport, I was with my best friend, and he wanted to get a green tea at Starbucks, and the line was like wrapped around. And I just looked at him and I said, this is part of why society is so sick, because this is what we're all engaging in. And so those plastic lids that come with your coffee, they have bisphenol A in them. And the steam of the hot coffee or the hot tea is diluting that, and it's falling into your drink. And so you're drinking it. It's like you're helping to further along the toxicity that you're getting from the lid. So BYOM, if you must, bring your own mug. Have some glass mugs safely stored in your car so you're never without one, and stop drinking with those plastic lids. Saran wrap is a no-no. Get glass storage containers with glass lids, because we have the same issue with the lids. So just go glass. what else? Saran wrap is a no-no. Make sure you're not wrapping your food in Saran wrap, which I think I just said. And receipts. When you pay for something and you get a credit card receipt or an airline receipt, those receipts have bisphenol A in them. So say no to receipts. Just say, I don't need the receipt. You're going to get it on your online statement, in your credit card. And so don't worry about grabbing the receipt, and make sure you're washing your hands, because as conscious as you are, there's still going to be ways that it's going to get into you. So before you eat, before you go to sleep, just wash your hands and just soap and water. Don't use those antibacterials. Those are no good and create super bugs. Let me see. I think there might be something here. Okay. Hi, Vanadeta. Nice to have you here. Just saying hi. So speaking of, also another source of bisphenol A would be composite fillings. And so mercury fillings, we mostly know, are very toxic. Mercury is a known toxin. It's one of those issues that leads to autoimmune disease. In a study that took thyroid cells and then put mercury into the thyroid cells in a petri dish, we could see the creation of antibodies against the thyroid. So we don't want to have mercury fillings, and then a lot of us go to the composite fillings, but those composite fillings also can have toxic chemicals in them in the plastic. So it's really important to speak to your dentist, make sure that when you're getting fillings, if you have cavities, that they're void of all those things. And there's a great test that I do on a lot of my patients, the Clifford test, and it helps you to see what dental materials you are going to react to and not react to. So that's a little bit about bisphenol A and just planting the seed about living a more plastic-free life. So that's one.